morning of April the 20th, 1999, 16-year-old Cassie Bernal handed her friend Amanda Meyer a note that said, "Honestly, I totally want to live my life completely for God. It's hard and scary, but totally worth it." Later that day, somebody pointed a gun to her head and said, "Do you believe in God?" "Yes." And they shot her to death. The morning of April 20th, 1999, 16-year-old Cassie Bernal handed her friend Amanda Meyer a note that said, "Honestly, I totally want to live my life completely for God. It's hard and scary, but totally worth it." Later that day, somebody pointed a gun to her head and said, "Do you believe in God?" "Yes." And they shot her to death. Okay, 19-year-old Cassie Bernal handed her down to there a note that said, "Honestly, I did it right. I'm taunting to the point of the gun. I'm looking up for a life. I'm taunting the tone of the gun. I'm taunting right now because of the 19-year-old
misunderstand. They say some temporal suffering, no future bliss can make up for it. But knowing that heaven, once attained, will work backwards, and turn even that agony into a glory. But of some sinful pleasure, they say, let me but have this, and I'll take the consequences. But in dreaming how damnation will spread back and back into their past, and contaminate the pleasure of the sea. Both processes begin even before death. Forgive man's past begins to change, so that his forgiven sins and remembered sorrows take on the quality of heaven. The bad man's past already conforms to his badness and is filled only with dreariness. And that is why, at the end of all things, when the sun rises here and the twilight turns to blackness down there, the blessed will say, we have never lived anywhere except in heaven, and the lost, we were always in hell, and both will speak truly.